Let us consider the concept of projectile. So what is this projectile? A body projected into the air at an angle other than 90 degree with the horizontal. Say this is theta angle and the body is projected like this with some velocity u. This is our horizontal. This body is called projectile. A body projected into the air at an angle other than 90 degree with the horizontal. So once the body is projected, we know that it is under the gravitational field influence. At every point, it experiences acceleration due to gravity downwards. Because of this, it cannot take this straight line path. It takes a curved path and falls onto the ground. So a body projected into the air at some angle cannot move along the straight line. It takes a curved path and finally falls on the ground. The path of this body, this projectile, is a parabola. The path along which the projectile moves is called parabola. Now, what is the definition of this projectile? So we can define it as a body projected into the air at an angle other than 90 degree with the horizontal. It is a body projected into the air at an angle other than 90 degree with the horizontal. If it is 90 degree, it becomes a vertically projected body. Now, let us consider body projected into the air, projected like this. Because of the gravitational force, it moves along this curved path. So we discussed path of the body is a parabola. Suppose if I say absence of gravity, in the absence of gravity, what is the path along which the projectile will travel? Simply, if I say gravitation is zero, so there is no downward pull on the body, therefore body moves along straight line path. So in the absence of gravity, it moves along straight line, but in the presence of gravity, it moves along parabolic. Now, let us consider the velocity of the body at the initial point u. Resolve this velocity into two components. This component becomes horizontal u cos. This component is vertical u sin theta. Component close to the vector is cos, away from the vector is sin. And here u, velocity, so we can resolve it into components, u cos theta along horizontal direction, u sin theta along vertical direction. I can say it is u y and this is u x. Now let us consider the position of the body, say this one, after a time t. If v is the velocity at this point, now what is the value of the v? We know that v is always equal to u plus at. Now let us first consider horizontal motion, horizontal direction. Since velocity is resolved into components, I am calculating the velocities along horizontal as well as vertical. So vx, which is ux plus a, acceleration. Body is moving only because of the gravitational pull, which acts vertically down and there is no horizontal influence. That means acceleration of the body in the horizontal direction is zero. Therefore, it is ux or u cos theta. The velocity of the body in the horizontal direction is ux or nothing but u cos theta. Now let us consider vertical motion or y direction. So let us take vy. Uy, since the body is projected into the air, a is minus g, so minus gt, or it is u sin theta minus gt. So at any instance of time, the velocity of the projectile is given by, so we are taking any instant in the path, let us take any instant, the velocity, nothing but x component square plus y component square. Suppose if I assume the body makes at this point velocity is tangential for the crude path. If I consider this angle is alpha, body makes an angle alpha with the horizontal, then from these two Vx and Vy equations I can write tan alpha as y component by x component. When the vector makes an angle alpha with x axis, then tan alpha is given by Vy by Vx, because this is our vector, this is y component, this is x component, this is Vx, this is Vy, this is my V. So if I call this as alpha, tan alpha is Vy by Vx, that means u sin theta minus gt divided by u cos theta. So using this relation, it is possible to measure the angle made by the velocity vector at any given instance of time t. If you observe these velocities, let us take horizontal direction, there is no dependence on time. That means throughout the motion, the horizontal component of velocity remains constant. Whether you take this point or this point or this one, wherever you consider, the horizontal velocity is constant. But if I consider the vertical motion, see, it is u sin theta minus gt. As t increases, this u sin theta minus t decreases. Means initially Vy decreases, becomes 0 at one point, that is called highest point, and then again increases but with a negative sign. Means as the body is moving up, the Vy value continuously decreases. At this point it becomes, vertical component becomes 0, and again as the moving down it increases. It is similar to the vertically projected body. When we project the body upwards, we know velocity decreases and finally becomes 0. That is the highest point, again it increases and finally falls on the ground. So here also vertical component throughout the motion changes, but horizontal component of velocity remains constant. So at which point velocity of the projectile is minimum? Let us take the highest point. Here we have only Vx, there is no Vy, because Vy becomes 0. Since net velocity is nothing but root of Vx square plus Vy square, and Vy is 0, velocity is minimum. So body will possess minimum velocity yet highest point. So velocity of projectile is minimum at the highest, then maximum. Maximum is possible at two points, initial point and also final, because same concept vertically projected. If I project the body with velocity u, again strikes the ground with the speed u, direction is reversed, magnitude remains same, here also same. Here if I say uy initial, when it strikes the ground, again it here uy. So at the initial and final points velocity is maximum, whereas at the highest point velocity is minimum.